hustling, man, I've been putting these hours. The government been trying to take over sours. Really all about the money and the power. I just wanna see my people in power. Tell me how we gon' shape this vision. Complaining all day, but in the same condition. If you wanna make change, it's gon' take commitment. Some people enslaved by their religion. Can't emancipate the fundamental principles. What I see through optics, transform the wisdom. Watch me use my prophets, them on the listen. I've been on a mission. And I really can't take it no more. I've been fighting temptations, my Lord. I'm young and I'm restless. And I really can't help it. I never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me? I said, Lord, can you help me? Everybody got fights, yeah, but wouldn't know what good advice was. Till I leave him lifeless. Nothing mama crying, it's another crisis. Lord knows we just trying to live righteous. Are you willing just to make the sacrifices? I know we can't continue living like this. And I never sell my soul cause that's priceless. Tell me how we gonna make a living. Hustle on the block, who gonna save the children? And it's all a plot and I'm just revealing. The media just trying to make a villain. I just take the pain to paint a picture. Voices in my head, I hear the whippers when I feel its weight. And I really can't take it no more. I've been fighting temptations, my Lord. I'm young and I'm restless. And I really can't help it. I never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me? I said, Lord, can you help me? It's just the way I feel. My been wasting so long. Not really can't take it no more. I've been fighting temptations, my Lord. I'm ringing on presence.
I said, Lord, can you help me?
I never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. To me, Lord, can you help me?
I said, Lord, can you help me?
Guys, we all watched the film yesterday, and I hope everyone knows it wasn't good enough. Today's practice has got to be great. You want to win a ball game, take advantage of your practice reps, because Sunday's going to be here before you know it. Hey, Mac, over here. We need to talk. Now, look, that was not a good practice. I don't know what's going on with you, but that's not going to get it done. We'll come stronger tomorrow, okay? Eyes up, men. Y'all need to take a hard look at today's performance. Coaches can only do so much. We can only create a game plan. We can't go out there and practice.
Feel the flame, hold on, I can make it rain. Oh, do you hear the thunder? No, don't let it bring you down. Look up and see the light. You're not alone, don't give up like that. Oh, we yeah, got a ways to go. Break that wall, let the spin out.
I know you ain't there yet. Don't stop to catch your breath. You're going higher and higher, higher and higher. Let go, set me free.
Montana. You know, I'm like, yeah, Ice P, you know?
What up, P?
Man.
The music of Harry Fry.
When I pull up, they notice me. Come and talk to me like Jodeci. But don't you be too close to me. Them goons you see, let it go for me. I bring them things, I bring them things. I call them, he bring them things. Mucho, I bring them things. Looking so expensive, rings and things. I bring them things.
Hello everybody, I'm Larry.
Here's Tucker now out to kick this one away. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. Oh, spinning away. A nice little juke. And he breaks it all the way out to the 38-yard line. Great return. So here comes the Packers offense now onto the field. They'll be led out by the former Cal Bear, Aaron Rodgers.
I guess we have to nickname him the thrower, aren't we, or something
after
like that.
After last week?
I mean, man, you got about over 400 yards throwing the ball. The running backs and everyone else may be looking at him like, hey, don't forget us. And he'd probably just tell him, listen, you want to get involved? Go out and catch some passes. I'll make sure you touch it.
Back to the air on second down. It's Rodgers. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. So here we go, first and 10 out. From the gun, it's Rodgers. Looking left side, it's a plate, he's got it. 12 more yards there and another first down. And this is a guy who last week not only helped his real team, but really helped a lot of fantasy teams. Three trips to pay dirt, they got to contain
him. And watching him, because I'm going to lunch with you when you order that combo play, right? In this case, his combo play is he can go over the top of you and catch it, get you in front, turn it into a big game, and pass you, and then uses his size and his physical abilities to keep you away from football. Hard to defend this guy.
Reigning NFC Offensive Player of the Week. Now the first carry for Ty Montgomery. And this time he's going backwards. So after the no gain on the last attempt, here they get him behind the line.
Okay, let's just make this one simple. We know that the running game is not their thing, but they can't just throw it on every single down without expecting some real heat from the pass rush.
A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
By no pass experience, before you actually play a game, you visualize what's going to happen. And I don't know anyone doesn't visualize themselves being the center of what's going on. That's three catches for him here in the early going. He's got to like the way this has started.
Absolutely. Three catches on any drive is good. Open drive, that's a tone setter.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
And he comes back with one complete. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal. Defensively, they better figure something out. Opening drive, he already has four catches.
And if you have to figure out how to stop him defensively, that usually...
And he's got it! It's caught for a Packers touchdown! Well, that's about as quick of a passing touchdown as you'll ever see right there.
Everyone has a section in their playbook called the quick game. That was a super quick game. Out of the hands of thrower, bam, right to the receiver, successfully for a touchdown.
How in-depth is that quick game part of the play? So after the INT, it's Rodgers. Quick hitter here. It's complete. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. How about the first quarter he's putting together out wide? Pretty impressive.
I think that likes his fact that we're playing this as a day game. You know, some guys, they respond better in the evenings, so for some reason, builds up. But this guy, day game, and he is off and running. You're exactly right. 100 might be conservative with the start he's had here in the first quarter.
Yeah, by the numbers, he's a pace for 200-plus right now. Throwing on first down is Rodgers. This will be caught at about the 5. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a...
And he is going to go down. Back the 11-yard line. C.J. Mosley. Tough to handle on that blitz. He gets him for a loss of 5. Throwing it, Rodgers on third down. And this is going to be incomplete. Here's Tucker now out to kick this one away. This one taken just inside the 10. And he'll be taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. Well, we have a minute. We remind you that later tonight we'll have a couple of NFC East rivals squaring off, the Eagles and the Cowboys from Big D.
Or Arlington. Got to make sure we get it right.
To be more precise there in the Metroplex. Then tomorrow at Week 11, we'll wrap up with a playoff rematch from the divisional round a year ago, the Falcons and Seahawks, but this time from Seattle.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers and to create a wall and let him pick his spot and run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. A very solid gain of 27. And he's over 100 yards now after that last catch. Only, of course, leading the NFL in receiving yardage.
So he's done nothing at all to hurt his cause to stay in that spot. But I've been so impressed with how he's gotten it done. Body control, route running. How about the way he competes for football at the end of the play?
And he'll take down shy of the 45 at the 46. The completion good for 3 and it's second down.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone. You're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
A good chance. This is 4 down territory. They're unable to convert, but right now looking at a 3rd and 3. Rodgers to throw once more. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. The 21 yards there as they convert on 3rd. Well, there's your leading receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage, putting on another clinic well over 100 yards.
Are we taking notes? We should be, right? Because I'm going to go back and watch this tape and really enjoy what I'm seeing. The route running, competing for the football, just breaking down a defense.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down.
Well, they get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you got to continue to try and run and try to keep the defense honest.
You mean, or else he'll just sit back, dare you throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at 3. That one goes for 16 yards. It sets him up 1st and goal. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We're back to Lambeau following these words. A reminder coming up at halftime when the two of us head for warm areas of the press box. Touchdown, Packers! So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start. And Green Bay getting ready.
go as they take the field.
And still a lot of football to be played in this season. We're only in November. A lot can happen between now and January. But if it ended today, they would just be on the outside of the playoff picture looking in. So a lot to fight for.
Yeah, wasn't it interesting in our meeting with the coaching staff that they all made sure to let us know. We know where we are right now. But the playoffs don't start tomorrow. We still got some time, and they plan on putting it together, formulating a streak, got the whole month of December still left to play. They think they can get in.
And they made it very obvious to us that there's no playoff talk in the locker room right now. It's win this game and look to next week.
Excellent focus.
Talk about a big first half. Already has the two touchdowns. Adding to his receiving total there, picking up the first down.
He's coming off the line so fast. I think he's intimidating the defensive backs with his explosiveness, and he's chipping away at their confidence.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
See, in that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays. Makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Because Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
Throwing now is Rodgers. Oh, the rookie nearly had the pick. Probably should have had it. Third down now. He's lucky to be getting that one back.
After what they've done with him all day long with all the targets trying to go after him, he's obviously gotten smart and his pride has kicked in.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Brandon Carr. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. So on fourth down, here's Sam Cook to punt it away. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And it's taken in at the 9. A beautiful fake. Oh, and now he bowls him over. So nothing separating these two teams as we head to the break. Sorry, Larry. Your hard work appreciated by so many men and women, but not today as we get back to the action in the second half. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You got everything going your way. You're probably prepared for maybe some changeups you might expect, but overall, you like what your game plan is showing you.
He finds Randall Cobb with a completion. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A good pickup there on 20 yards.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. To throw on third down, Rodgers. And he can't hang on to it. Nearly picked. He's known for his hands defensively. Here's Sam Cook now. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away. And boy, it's another boomer. This will be down just inside the 30-yard line.
the Packers offense now heading back out onto the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
On second down, here's Rodgers. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Now, he's certainly been a huge factor in this one. He's got the two touchdowns to his credit. Now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him, double him, triple him, do what you have to do. But sometimes they get locked into such a groove and such a connection, it doesn't matter how many guys are in his area.
He certainly looks to be in that groove right now. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
I think many people thought Ty Montgomery would automatically go back to being a wide receiver this year, but it appears he's going to stay at running back. I know they drafted Jamal Williams from BYU, but Montgomery proving his worth.
And he proved it, yeah, proved it last year. 5.4 yards per carry, fourth best in the league. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. Rodgers now on first down. His throw is going to be incomplete. The new acquisition, Martellus Bennett, the intended target. And that'll bring up second down. But not to get too overcritical there, because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do, and it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He had told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up on the top shelf where the kids can't get it.
They stay on the ground this time. It's Williams. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
Into the red zone, it's Rodgers. This will be caught just inside the 10. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion. Back now at Lambeau. All even as we get ready to start the fourth. On second down, Montgomery. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. 6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves him with a first and goal.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation,
and he's got it. It's caught for a Packers touchdown.
And that third counter there gives them.
Set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. On first down, Rodgers. And he's got his man on the out route. 12 yards there as they move the chains. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. Sack. He took a hit on that last play. Now let's see how he and the offense respond on second. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line.
12 yards is the pickup there. And that's going to lead to a third down.
Look, the first down marker is out there, but sometimes it's hard to find for an offense when you're in a long yardage situation, which usually means throw the football. In this case, they went against the tendency and ran it. And boy, the reward was there. A big, big pickup. And guess what? It's now third and very short in order to try and pick up a first down.
Rodgers now on first down. And it's incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. Rodgers will try again on second down. And this time, he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. And a nice gain of 21 yards. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Time for a break. We'll come back and see how it all shakes out after this. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They've got it first and 10 as they search for a go-ahead score. First down, here's the run with Montgomery. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
Here's Rodgers to throw. And Nelson's got it here right side. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. 18 yards there, and it'll be a first and goal. He has been terrific today, hasn't he?
Yeah, absolutely. Running flawless two-minute drill right here. This has been quarterbacking 101 with a flourish.
To throw is Rodgers. Touchdown, Packers! And the Browns, they surge back to take the lead there. DeShone Kizer, a touchdown pass to help lead the way. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Now the Packers get set to go. They have a little bit of time here to get into field goal range. Not much. A tie game, you don't want to do anything crazy, right?
I agree with you on that one. Risk reward, okay? If you go for it, what is the absolute reward on this? But the risk is probably greater. Run the clock out, get to overtime, and try and win it there.
All right, we'll see if they do just that. Again, they'll go ground with Montgomery. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the...
Here's Sam Cook now, on for a very important punt here in overtime. Fielded at the 20. A good return there, 17 yards. And it'll be Packer football here, first down and 10. Now trotting out there, the Packers getting ready to go. Their defense did its job, got the stop. All they need is 3, and this is over.
Couldn't have done much else other than score themselves and end it, but they turned it back over to them, and now all they need is a field goal to win the game. An excellent job by the defense. Can the offense finish things off?
Now part one is done, now part two. Rodgers again here on 2nd and 10. And he comes back with one complete. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. And it's a memorable catch because it's the single best reception performance in a game in league history.
How much fun has this been today for us, though, to watch this type of performance, Mr. Glue Fingers himself, establishing a brand new record in the NFL.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. 2 minutes to go here in overtime. We'll be back after this. Again, they'll throw with Rodgers. Oh, he almost had it. Would have been a big interception here in OT. Instead, it'll give him another shot on third down.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well. When you're trying to win a game in overtime, I don't know that there's too many more in the history of the game you want under center than Aaron Rodgers.
Well, I think a lot of it's because he can beat you so many different ways. All right, he can beat you with the big shot downfield. Heck, if you need a Hail Mary, no one throws it better than Aaron Rodgers. But just when you think you've got him corralled in, when you've got pressure on him, he uses his legs to escape and create another big play, whether he's running it or extending it so a receiver gets open. I think he embraces overtime, and he embraces the spotlight that comes with it. That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down because they had the incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains. They go back to that well. He's had a great game. Defensively, they haven't been able to stop him. Same thing here in overtime.
And sometimes that goes to the play caller's ego because a lot of times you have so many different plays you want to call. But when you spot a matchup that's working for you or a player that has the hot hand, keep giving it to him. That tells me you're mature as a play caller and it's working for them in overtime.
Rodgers to throw on second down. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. Call it a gain of 3, and it'll be third down. Well, right now, every little bit of yardage helps. So they're obviously well within his range. It's just about keeping the football and getting in the right spot.
Know your kicker. Get, as you mentioned, get it to the right spot, the place that he wants to kick it from. And if you do decide to throw the football, it either goes to your team or no one. It's the only kind of throw you make.
It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. On first and 10, here's Rodgers. This will be caught at about the 6. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. A gain of 6 there on first. He's padding his already great numbers here in overtime. More importantly, though, moving his guys downfield.
And I think that's exactly what's going through his head right now. Moving them downfield, putting them in a position to win the game. The stats, that's for the fantasy guys. I know they're enjoying that show.
So that's it. No double overtime until the playoffs rolled around, so that means this one ends in a tie.
Yeah, that's ultimately unsatisfying for both teams, the fans. Heck, for us.
True. We came here to see...